okay, back to the story. So there was this time when we were still in high school, like 2 years ago, and Aileen came over to my house, and it was on a weekend, and we wanted to have a movie night, but we wanted snacks, and there's a gas station like right around the corner from where I live. So we were like, fuck it, let's go walking. So yeah, we went walking, and so we're getting into like, so on it's like the sidewalk, and then you know how it like bends down so like the cars could go through there, like the entrance for the cars. We started to get to there, and then there was like a van right there, and he was just staring at us hard. So then this bitch le hace una seña, like, what the fuck, you know, like, what are you looking at, what's your problem, que se te perdió. And then I thought this bitch was just trying to be funny or something and said hi to him. And then she was like, nah, like, that's not what I meant. Like, I was just, like, you know, looking at him like, what the fuck is your problem? And then we go into the store. We buy our shit. We're over here being silly.
But we take a while in there.
Yeah, we do take a while because también había una línea and people were trying to get gas too. So yeah. So then we finally pay for our stuff. We go out. Keep in mind, when we came out, we did not see the van. We didn't see him at all. Like,
he had already left. That's so we thought.
Yeah. So we start walking.
I think it's like a cool like 10 minutes into our walk.
Yeah, like a good 10 minutes into our, no, not even. No, yeah. Because that's in 15 minutes walking to the thing. And then and we're like 5 minutes away from my house. So all of a sudden, she notices that there's a van following us. And then I turned around and then I was like, oh shit, you know, like we are. And then
he rolls down his window.
And then before he rolls down his window, this bitch like, hey, that's the same nigga from the gas station. And then I was like, what do you mean?
She didn't believe me.
I didn't because honestly, yo ni me acordé.
Yeah.
Like, I wasn't really thinking about all that. And then, she was like, Stephanie, like, that's the nigga. And then I was like, okay, well, let it be. Like, what the fuck is he gonna do to us? We're on, a big street. Anybody could pass by here any minute if he tries to do something. And plus, I was like, we have phones. Like, we could call someone or whatever.
But this whole time, my fear was that he was gonna make a U-turn. Remember, I was like, dude, he's gonna fucking make a U-turn. Because didn't he have his turn signals on?
He had his emergency lights on.
Yeah.
So then this bitch, she's freaking out, like, big time, like anxiety type of freaking out. Panic attack. And then,
I'm like, I start yelling, like, oh, I'm gonna fucking call the cops, I'm gonna call the cops. Because at this time, he's giving us a sign, like, get in the car, or, like, come in the car, you know? So I start freaking the fuck out, like, man, I was sequestrad or some shit.
Ay, Nick, tú ya estás buena, tú.
Bitch, I'm gonna And so I started freaking tripping. And I was like, somebody, I'm gonna call the cops. Somebody, I'm gonna call the cops. And she's like, no, don't. I was like, I don't give a fuck about him. Like, I'm about to call the fucking cops.
So honestly, up to now, I'm kind of stressed out because of this bitch. So I start yelling something to him. I don't know what the fuck I start yelling.
And I think he got scared when, like, I was like, oh, I'm gonna call the cops.
Yeah, and then this bitch turned around. She's like, I'm gonna call the fucking cops.
And I was already dialing it.
Yeah, she was literally dialing it. And then I was like, fuck, like, well, yeah, you know, he doesn't leave, so might as well fucking call him. But after she started to yell that shit, he fucking left. And, like, all the way back home, like, we were just looking our backs. Like, we kept looking. And literally, that's the last and first time we ever went walking somewhere, huh?
Yeah, now that I think about it, he was fucking waiting for us in that little street. Remember the street we cut through?
He probably thought about it. These bitches came from over there. Yeah. They were walking. Might as well. Oh, for real?
Yeah, dude.
But yeah, that
dude, and now that I think about it, you know the street we cut through to get to the gas station?
Yeah.
Imagine we would have cut through that same street. We would have fucking got, like,
and we were, but then me and you were like, nah, it's darker. Yes, están solas. Let's just take the long way.
Yeah.
And then my mom had told us too. She was like, by the time you guys get back or coming back, ya está oscuro. Take the big street. Who cares?
Yeah.
First and last time. And keep in mind, my mom never really let us do that stuff, huh?
No.
She would never. Nano's
my mom, but I would just do that because I would come here.
Yeah. But I guess my mom, she just thought, you know, like, these bitches are older. Yes, I didn't guess it.
How old were we, like, 17?
Yeah.
Because we still hadn't graduated high school. I think we were, like, 17. Like, that's fucking dangerous. Like, any thing could fucking happen even during the fucking day.
Okay.
You know?
But yeah, that shit was something else. And at first I was cool about it, but then I started to freak out because he wouldn't fucking leave.
Mm-hmm. And I feel like if I wouldn't have opened up my phone and started saying that, he wouldn't fucking leave. I feel like he would have busted a U-turn.
And we weren't even all dressed up or anything. Like, we weren't wearing anything to, like, to be like, oh, well, you bitches asked for it for what you guys were wearing. Well, no.
And I think he was like, andale, andale. I was like, what the fuck? You know? Hola.
Estoy grabando, ¿no? ¿Quieres salir en el video?
She's like, fuck no.
Okay, and then there was this other time in our single days. We went to a flyer party, and I think it was one of the first flyer parties. So yeah, it was one of our first flyer parties, and we used to have more friends back then.
Well, at least we thought so.
Were
like party friends, you know, like, you know when you stop partying and you tell them, oh, I'm gonna stop partying, they stop hitting you up.
Yeah.
Yeah, those were our friends.
So we would always like get tables or whatever, and there's these guys next to us. It was literally all girls and then like three guys with us. And there's these guys next to us, and keep in mind, they're older men.
Like men that shouldn't be at that fucking party.
Yeah, and they're just there because they just feel like they're the shit because they have money.
Yeah.
You get me? Like those old wannabe buchones.
Like, los dons que se creen que son narcos.
Yeah. So, there is this one friend, let's give her a nickname.
Oh. I don't know.
Stacy.
So white, but yeah. Yeah.
So, Stacy over here.
Being a hoe.
She was like the prettiest one. I'm not gonna even lie.
Yeah.
Hold on, I'm popping a pimple.
Let me see.
I took it off.
Fuck, man, I wanted a puppy.
Sorry. So don't get me wrong, she's really pretty. I still think she's really pretty. I don't have nothing against her, but we just stopped talking because, you know, I stopped partying. So,
I don't think she's doing some shit to me. There's a fucking shit right here with me. I was like, damn, bitch, you're going hella in. She's wiping her thing.
So then what? Oh, yeah, so these men's. These men's.
Niggas.
Well, no, they're men. Like, they're not no niggas, you know? Like, they're men. And they start.
Men's is a word?
Men. These men, because M-E-N is plural, M-A-N is one. Singular. Okay. Sorry, my English is broken, okay?
I was like, what the fuck?
So yeah. These men start asking her out to dance or whatever. And she doesn't want to. And they keep insisting. So then one of the guys, they fucking noticed that they were bugging. So knowing how fucking niggas are, se le acercan a los güeyes esos. And then we get into this big ass scene, right? And they're acting tough as fuck, you know, like tough as fuck. Well, skipping like the whole detail shit about like everything, turns out to be that we almost got shot. We almost got shot. They had guns with them, and I don't know how we got out of that. That's honestly another reason why me and her stopped flirting too.
And because we got boyfriends that control us, you know?
Not that they control us, we respect them. Or at least I respect mine.
I do too. What are you trying to say, bitch?
That Diego controls you, maybe? I don't know.
Do I go out?
No, but...
Fucking! I'm kidding.
No, fuck you.
I'm sick.
Okay.
These eyeshadows are like glitter. It's weird. It's a look. Let me find out you're doing that makeup look from those ugly ass filters on Snapchat. The chola one with the eyebrows?
Fuck you.
No, go like this, look. And it looks like it, watch.
It was her first, like, she was recién single and she wanted to go party.
Bitch, I was like 2 days single. Yeah, because I broke up with the guy I was with on a Wednesday.
Well, total, she was single, she became single, whatever. She wanted to go party, you know, the typical recién single bitch, you know.
Typical celebración, you know?
Yeah. So we fucking go to the party, whatever. Who was there? Who else was there? It was Ramon, Jocelyn, Keitsia.
Oh yeah.
Who else was? I think Carolina too.
Austin, David, Austin, Ramirez. Yeah. All of them, that whole little group.
Janet. Like, I'm forgetting more
Jaime,
people.
Jaime, his sister, all his girlfriends.
So we're all having a good time, whatever. Somehow, I don't know how, me and her got separated. I don't know where she went, I don't know where I went.
I think because I want to go dance. And I remember that day, like, I was already getting drunk, dude. And I remember I went to the restroom. Mm-hmm. Fuck, there's some girl that I knew that I met, and like I have her on Instagram, and like I remember she sees me, and like I'm already out there, I'm already fucking buzzed, dude, like everything's fucking blurry. The restrooms were flooded, bitch. Like I stepped into that fucking restroom, my whole foot was under fucking water.
Ew.
It was disgusting. And then she sees me and she started like smacking my ass, and I started twerking, dude.
Bitch,
on top of the sink, and I know, I was like, what the fuck am I doing? And I was like, what the fuck am I even doing? I was already fucked up, so me and her just lose communication. Like, I don't know where she's at, she doesn't know where I'm at.
So point is, Brian, this guy comes up to him, and then he's like, hey, I think I have you on Instagram. He was like, don't you play the accordion? Y que no sé qué. My brother's like, oh yeah, you know? And then the guy was like, oh yeah, you guys are cool as fuck. You guys come sit at the VIP table, que no sé qué. So Brian's asking for permission if he could go. And then I was like, well, I don't know. Like, I don't know who the fuck is there or anything, you know? Like, I don't want to leave him alone. Because, I mean, he was how old? He's 16 14. Now. Yeah, he was 14. And it was one of his very first parties, too. So I was like, well, I was like, yeah, you could go. But let me go check where exactly you're going to be. So then, that's when I finally see this bitch is just coming out the restrooms. And, so, we already trying to balance. Like, we're already tired, and it was already kind of late. It was, like, 1 a.m. And we already want to balance, but Brian was having such a good time that he was like, come on, just, like, un ratito más, you know? Like, let me enjoy. And I think he was going to play the accordion that time. And so I was like, okay, you know what? Let's go. So me, Eileen, Janet, y nomás, we all go to...
those girls.
Yeah, we went to go sit down at the tables that were... Some tables that were outside. And we're all just sitting there chilling, right? And then out of nowhere, it's like a black girl. And like a whole group of other like spice-ass bitches. Mm-hmm. And shit, and like they're all like talking shit to each other, and like, you know. And then so the black girls, they were like, you know what, like, we don't really want to fight because, you know, we just came to have fun. And then like the paisa bitches, they were all like, nah, that, you know, you over here mad dogging us, like, you know, okay, so it's pointless, they're all over here fucking fighting and shit. So then this guy was with like the black girls, and then and then the paisas had these other, it was just one guy, and the other ones were like three guys. Well, the three guys are trying to separate them all. And then the one guy with the paisa girls, they're all like, just like, they're
like, but keep in mind, I think one was like a security or some shit. Remember?
Yeah, but he came with the negritas.
Yeah.
I hope nobody gets offended because I said negrita and black girl.
No offense.
Like, it's because nowadays everybody gets offended over any little shit. Just saying, you know? But, so, the guy that was with the paisitas, like, he's enjoying this. Like, he's not even doing anything to, like, separate them. He's doing nothing. Like, he's just chilling there, having the time of his life.
Literally.
So,
time is 38.
So then the guys were like, the other three guys, they were telling him, like, hey, nigga, like, grab your girls, like, we're trying to calm shit down, like, this is just, a cool party, you know, like, we're all just trying to chill. And the guy, he gets mad about it, he starts, like, cursing at them, and then he's all like, I don't give a fuck who the fuck you think you are, I don't give a fuck if you're the fucking security, he was like, ahorita le saco plomo a todos, y que no sé qué. And then I was like, what the fuck? Like, what the fuck is going on? Keep in mind, literally, this is us on the bench. And then they're literally in front of us. Yeah. So we're like, what the, you know? And then,
point is, like, they wouldn't fucking calm down. So one of the dudes, like, lifts up his shirt. And he's like, se calman o los calmo. Huh.
Oh, yeah.
And I was like, oh, my God, we're about to all fucking die. Like, somebody's about to get shot.
The other guy, he could be running around. You're not being chavala perdida. You never know where that shit goes to.
Yeah. Point is, don't go to Desvelados. It's all a bunch of underage people drinking and smoking fucking weed. You know, but and his face getting raided. Remember when I said Desvelada and Conjunto Brio Norteño was gonna be there?
And we had to leave. Why did we end up leaving?
Because it got raided. Because we were about to leave, I don't know why, and then we go outside and the cops are already there.
Oh, yeah. Oh, here's a funny story from me. There is this party. And one of my bestest friends ever invited me, Austin. And yeah, I went with him and okay, whatever. I invited my friend Janet. And yeah, like everything was cool, whatever. But then the cops ended up showing up and well, of course, we have to fucking leave. So the party that we were at, it was like down the block from my boyfriend's house. And I remember I already had like a couple of days that I didn't see him because he would go out of town to work. And that's when he was like driving. When he worked driving. And I wanted to see him, and then my friends, they wanted to go to Jack in the Box. So I met up with my boyfriend or whatever, and we were hanging out. And then I wanted to be more time with him. And so Austin and Janet left me right there with him. So So I wanted to stay more time with him, and I fucking did. So yeah, me quedé con el otro rato, and keep in mind, my phone had already, is like, in low percentage. Where the fuck are my eyelashes? They were right here.
Right here. Oh, I'm gonna... Do you still use the ones that I gave you? Are those it?
Yeah, I still have
those. Those are here? That us?
No, I wore them yesterday, and they were there by the window. I took them off last day. And then, so my phone dies. And my mom is pretty smart. My mom, she stayed up until she heard that I was home. And I usually get home from a party like around 2 or so. And this time it was a little bit more late. So she was like, what the fuck, you know? She knows that I left with Austin and my friend Janet. And...
But did she show up with them? No.
No, I did not. So... My phone fucking dies, and I guess my mom, she's been calling me, and she hears Austin's truck pull up, right? So I guess she wants to go check if she sees me get out of the truck or whatever. And I don't come out of the truck. So she's like, where the fuck is she? ¿Para dónde se metió esta hija de chingada? Literally her words. And I guess she's calling me, and I'm not answering because, you know, my phone's over here dead or whatever. And whatnot. So she's freaking out. So my mom, she calls Janet, my friend. She lives next door. That's why she's seen everything. She's my neighbor. So technically she only seen Janet get off the truck and not me. So yeah. So my mom starts calling Janet, and then Janet's kind of drunk. And when Janet's drunk, she's... Alright, hi guys. So we had to do our makeup ahead of time. Well, not ahead of time, but like without recording. Reason being why is because my phone said I had full storage, so I had to go delete pictures.
Brian, you're ugly, I can't.
Come, Brian, come say hi.
No.
What?
So we had to do our makeup off camera.
Oh, yeah, we had to do our makeup off camera because, because of that, so I had to delete pictures, messages, and apps. But here I am. I can go on with the video. But point is that.
Sorry. Damn, man, I'm fucking ugly. I can't.
And
this is my bad side. Is that a look?
Anyways.
No, it's not a look.
What was it?
Your mom was tripping.
Oh yeah, so my mom was tripping, and then, well, she had a reason to. I'm not gonna sit here and act like she didn't have a reason to. And then.
Oh, my mom's just
dumb. And then what? Oh yeah, so I'm going up the stairs. Like, I finally get home, I get dropped off, and I'm going up the stairs, and my mom pops out of nowhere, and she slaps me. She slaps me on this cheek. Like, really?
Better work this time.
Okay, so sorry, I'm having some technical difficulties, but yeah, she slapped me, and yeah, that's pretty much it. I had another story in my head. Oh my god, you guys. Okay, so me and my boyfriend decided to go to a little road trip the other day, like around 12 in the morning, and we went all the way up to almost getting to Forest Falls, and he was like, hey, you want to go to the crazy hospital? So
that's
we went. Yeah. We went to it, and it's fucking creepy. Like, you go in, and it reminded me, you know what? Of, like, a college with the little apartments, the condos type of thing. It was scary as fuck. And then, like, the codes on the house were kind of scary too.
The codes?
Yeah, there was like, it was like A something something. Like, you know how the address of our house is just like, you know, like
yeah,
1, 2, 3?
What's the history about that?
Okay, so I was reading the comments on the internet, and it said, like, ex-patients, like patients that used to be there,
yeah,
go on the fucking reviews and say what they've been through there and how they try to do something about the about it, but the government won't do shit about it.
Fuck.
So there is this one that said, she even said the specific names of the specific doctors or nurses or whatever they do that are there taking care of everybody.
Wait, so it's still on?
Oh, yeah. Dude, you know what I'm missing? I'm missing something for my makeup. Watch. So yeah. So we're looking at the comments or whatever, and she says that she got raped. Not only her, but like other people that work there, I mean that are patients there, have gotten raped too. And los drogan a propósito. So they can calm down or fall asleep and then do whatever the fuck they want with them. They're abusive. They beat the fuck out of them. Like, it's bad. Like, that hospital has really bad reputation. And I don't think that's the only hospital. I'm pretty sure there's where, like, the mental people are at. I'm pretty sure all of them are bad hospitals. So, yeah. So, we pull up. We're, like, by the light. And then my boyfriend was like, take a picture of it for your vlog. And then I was like, okay, I'm gonna take a picture of it, but, like, they're gonna want like something else, you know, like make it interesting, some shit, you know. So he was like, let's go.
Wait,
in.
So there's still people in there?
Yes, bitch. There's a part that it's a museum, and then the other part is the actual hospital. Watch when they're gonna take you.
Fuck no.
But during the daytime, because you're a little pussy.
I don't know that bullshit.
Oh shit. So then, sorry. So my boyfriend was like, well, let's go in. And I was like, we're gonna go in. He was like, well, not in, but like, you know, like, let's go in through the, like, to make the turn into the place. Mm. So we made the turn into the place, and it's fucking creepy. Like, you get like a creepy ass vibe. And my boyfriend, he's not the type to get scared by anything, you know. And he was actually shooting bricks too. So yeah, and so we park. And right where we park, se prende una lucecita.
Stop.
I swear. I was like, babe, you seen that shit? And he was like, what, the light? And I was like, yup. And then, excuse my brother's arguing. So we're over here like, fuck, they're watching us. Bomb. So me and Bert were like, they're watching us. And obviously like they fucking people? Are. No, but it's like the security guards and all them. You know, because you're not allowed to go in and put footage and shit. Oh. There's a sign that before you enter says you can't put any footage or pictures unless you have permission.
What the fuck?
Yeah. So.
For a fucking reason, not just because, you know.
Exactly. So. We finally, like. We're giving it, like, we finally get off our parking spot because that light just creeped us out. So, we get to the sign where it's, like, the sign of directions, like, if you want to go to the, like, administration, et cetera, et cetera. So, we're literally parked in front of administration. And, it's security administration, and, like, we're right in between. And we just start recording, and we're just chilling there for a long time. Like, a good five minutes just, like, not even parked, no nothing. Like, we just stood there. When all of a fucking sudden, dude, an undercover cop pulls up behind us. So we start moving and he starts following us. Like, whatever turn we made.
He made it.
So everyone was shooting bricks, you know, because they could actually do something to us. So he was like, you know what, let's just get out. So once he sees that we're going to go through the exit, he parks, right? He parks, so I'm expecting, like, let's say that it's not an undercover. Well, we thought it was an undercover cop. It's not, we don't know. But he was following us, that's for sure. So, also, yeah, so.
Mira, pones de seca.
Okay.
Close it.
Well, espérate.
Oh, you're burning.
Yeah. So then,
I think this one, huh?
Yeah. So then, so what?
So he parks.
And also, like, we finally get to, like, the exit. And, I mean, let's say that that person was someone that worked there or something. Wouldn't you expect them to get out of their car and go to wherever they have to go to? Well, no, like, we stopped there, and I looked back, and I waited for that person to get out the car. He never got out the car.
Why?
Ever. I guess he was just waiting for us to exit, because we're not allowed to be there. And plus, it was, like, 12, 1 in the morning. You know? But I have footage, and I'll play it.
No.
No. No, just kidding. But, yeah. That's pretty much it for our video. This was our final lick.
Boring as fuck.
Boring as fuck, but here we are, as we promised. A little bit of tea. And, yeah. All right, can you, like, you can press the button now.
Cut. I'm just kidding.
Go forward. Oh my god, we're going? Babe, what the fuck? What are they seeing me recording? Are these regular houses?
Look, no photo prints, bitch.
Oh shit. Should I be scared?
Better turn off the flash. I'm gonna check it out. What, I'm gonna park right here? I can go one of these cars.
Babe. It won't focus. Fuck. Babe, do you think there's a spirit in front of me?
Look, I don't know what there is in front of it, but you know where I know this much?
What?
We're being watched. You seen that light that just turned on?
Yeah.
Exactly. I'm telling you, we're being watched.
Yo, why do I got such bad quality, babe? Like, all of a fucking sudden, too.
Focus.
I'm trying, babe.
There you go.
Look, you guys. Okay, let's leave before we got someone on our asses.
You know, me and myself, I
it
never...
It turned off.
You know, me and myself, I never been here, and I'm tripping out. I always pass by it. I never, like, actually came in into this room.
All right, let's go. I feel so watched.
What the fuck?
Babe, what if all of a sudden you start hearing, like, someone in there crazy yelling?